AVC has it going. Right, okay, very quick video. Right, this is what I'm playing in the background, or you'll hear playing in the background in a minute. This is the Ramsey Lewis Trio, Another Voyage, on Chess Records, 1969. You know what you're getting with Ramsey Lewis, you know, can't complain, it's a great stuff. Right, okay. I haven't picked up too much over the last few weeks. I mentioned I went to a record fair and bought quite a lot of stuff three or four weeks ago now, something like that. I bought a lot of 7-inches, and so I've just been going through those, cleaning them up and giving them a spin. So stuff like Funkadelic, Cosmic Slop, Eddie Harris, Wait Please on Atlantic, People's Choice, Big Ladies Man, really nice soul tune that one. And this is Lloyd Price, They Get Down. Now Lloyd Price, I've been listening to this album quite a bit over the last few weeks. This is Lloyd Price, Mr. Personality, 15 hits. Now he made a lot of these sort of almost novelty R&B records in the late 50s, early 60s. Yeah, really nice stuff, really enjoyable. But these early 70s 45s that he put out on this label, GSF Records, are just straight funk, definitely worth picking out, picking up if you see them. I've got two or three of them now, I think. Always cheap, always less than a quid, pretty much what I've been paying. I'll do a needle drop on some of these 45s at the end of the video, so yeah, stick around and check it out. Cool. Right, okay. Also from the record fair, I picked this up. This is Marvin Gaye, I Want You. 1975 on Tamla Motown. I always find it fascinating, actually, the progression for Marvin Gaye. Think about that as mid-60s, straight soul records through to I Heard It Through the Grapevine, onto What's Going On. You know, then on to Let's Get It On, and then you end up here, say, mid-70s. It's quite a development, really, just in the whole sound, production, and songwriting as well. Fascinating stuff. He doesn't really get the credit for that he deserves. I think he, everyone recognises him as being a great singer, or he was a great singer. That beautiful soul voice, and of course, What's Going On is one of the greatest records of all time. But the other stuff around it sometimes get overlooked, and I think this is an underrated Marvin album. I think even the record, I think it's the record after this, Here My Dear, with the whole backstory of his divorce and such like, that always gets a bit more attention than this. But this is a beautiful record, definitely worth checking out if you haven't heard it. Right, also from the same seller at the fair, last one. This is an A Fox at Memphis. Let's turn that down a little bit. This is something that I've been after for quite a while now. I mean, she had a massive hit in the early 60s with Charlie Fox. It was Charlie and A Fox, called Mockingbird. Wonderful soul tune, been covered by every man and his dog. Aretha Franklin did a great version of it in the early 60s. But this is an album that came out in 1973 on Stax Records. I'd definitely recommend this. It is just straight Southern soul. I mean, look at that cover, that artwork. I mean, that's just, that photograph is just crazy, isn't it? Look at those eyes. But yeah, brilliant album. I say, one I've been after years, and this is just a lovely copy of it, so very good. I also picked this up, actually, from the same seller. This is only a couple of quid. Something I didn't know anything about, a guy called Louis Paul. It's on Stax, well, it's on Stax Offshoot Enterprise. It's a promo copy, so it only cost me a couple of quid. It's not soulful at all, it's more country than anything. The first track has got a bit of funk to it, but that's about it. Yeah, it's okay. I only picked it up because of the label it was on, and I didn't recognise it. But yeah, if anybody knows anything about it, like, give me a shout, I'm quite interested to find out more. Right, something I picked up a few weeks ago now. This is from eBay, an eBay seller, Augustus Pablo Eitel Dub. Now it's funny, I mean, well, first of all, this, I thought I was getting a real bargain with this. I thought it was an original copy. There wasn't much information on the eBay posting, just a couple of pictures, and looking at it, I was sure that it was an original pressing. It's not. It originally came in 75, I think this is an early 80s pressing on Trojan. Nice stuff though. Like I say, I got it a pittance, so it's worth what I paid. So, but yeah, I just find it interesting because I think that Augustus Pablo playing the melodica on this dub reggae sound works perfectly, but I can't think of any other context where I'd want to hear somebody playing a melodica. I don't know what it is, but I say it works great on this sort of dub sound, but anything else, I just can't imagine myself ever listening to it. But yeah, you can't knock Augustus Pablo there, can you? So, but very nice.